So, once again, after restarting a game that I was already playing, I've restarted a game that I was already playing again because I invested very little time into it, and I had audio issues, which I had to iron out. Pay the iron price. Tonight, I gotta make up for some time that I lost a little bit earlier. I would like to get at least to, I'm gonna say Capitan. I think that would be a good span of space. You know, who knows, maybe I'll stay up all night and play straight through back to Simafort. Reiterating what I was saying earlier, what I'm gonna go ahead and do here is play through basically the same, no power leveling. I'm just going to run from a few fights here and there, but overall try to stay decently and evenly leveled. Here we got my one of my favorite video game girls of all time. She has my three favorite things. She's a cat, and she has red hair, and she's a girl. Cats and girls are very similar if you think about it. To quote the great Miyamoto, cats are kind of like girls. If they talk to you, it's great, but if you try to talk to them, it doesn't always go so well. But anyway, the differences. Not gonna be fishing 24/7, because that's very tedious for you and tedious for me. I'm gonna hunt a little bit here and there, because that's quicker and more enjoyable and more profitable. Last night, I went ahead and pre-hunted about 72 roasts, 8 stacks, and those are going to sell for 14,400 zenny. I'm not going to sell them all at once, I'll just hold on to them, but that's going to be a nice nest egg to get me going that I actually earned just off camera, which I'll probably go ahead and try to do that a little bit between each episode anyway. And the zoom feature, or the speed feature, the button, I will not be pressing that as much, though I may go ahead and press it at Tiro's request, occasionally accompanied by Yakety Sax. I got very addicted to it in Breath of Fire 1 due to the nature of that master run, having no random battles and a lot of backtracking. And I got a little too used to it and couldn't quit using it, but I feel that it really detracts from the simulation of Super Nintendo hardware. Much like the much-aboard save state that I've been known to occasionally use for the purposes of stream stuff. Nina, my queen. pretty OP level-wise. Yeah, at this point I really don't know what to talk about. I rambled last time, I rambled the time before that. My apologies, Dine. I was actually starting earlier and then I had something come up where, okay, I won't lie, Game of Thrones came up. I'm mostly just going to be trying to get back to where I was, at Sima Ford. Without the eternal fishing. I do like the fact that Tunlin kind of, survived thousands of years, well, hundreds of years, however long it has been. And Sten's just about as useful in the opening as he is in the rest of the game. Watching Fresh Prince of Bel-Air is never a bad idea. 500? There's an official timeline now? I'm on board with that. That would be useful if you could find that. Well, so far as I can tell, I'm not dropping any frames in 720p. As I said before, usually I just use Ryu, Kat, Nina, and Rand. But this time I am gonna go ahead and continue to try to use everyone equally. Including Jean. Little bird, he says, must be talking about Sansa Stark. Because I make Game of Thrones references then. Freeze, like, winter is coming. The Pepe Le Pew of frogs, indeed. To be quite honest, I would like to get back into Ark the Lad. Ooh, they released an art book in September? Wow, I just know nothing. Much like Jon Snow. Gza! I'm very confused. I gotcha. No, I did not beat 3. In fact, I didn't even beat 2. I'm restarting. I made some poor decisions. Well, I'm sure that, Aspera is not that great in battle, but, I may have to go ahead and use him slash her anyway. Hey, whereas Sten's demo proved nothing other than he dies a lot. Oh. Jean? I gotcha. That makes a lot of sense. Jean. That does sound much more French. And you know my love of things that are French. Actually, maybe you don't know my love of things that are French. Basically, I like French things. Toast would probably be the top of that list. To the point of, I really wish I had some French toast right now. But I don't. Oh, that was the last title demo. As you'll see, I've got my 72 roast save up there right now. Just saves us trouble. And we're gonna try to make some good time. A couple bosses an hour, I think, is efficient. Yeah, I don't want any part of that. What projects do you have lined up, Dine? I will definitely be curious to see how the quality of that looks. Lots of God, God, God. Start off in a church. Definitely a, some sort of a theme I'm seeing. How could they even bring this game over without constantly referencing God or religion in some form? I don't see how that's possible. Without completely, like, murdering the story. Not to be confused with murdering the translation. Tree pole, that's not gonna do me much good. Ooh, Shadow of the Colossus. I've never played it, I'm interested. And yes, I will go find my sister. And interestingly enough, my IRL sister sent me a text just as I said that. Apologies. I have to pick up a CRT tomorrow from a friend because I miss playing SNES and PS1 games on an actual CRT TV. Mine is yellow right now. The tubes are dying. I'm at Tedragon. Oh, I see what you're saying. The text I got. Kyle, I'm at to dragon. See you there. I like that. It said nothing like that. More like, I am at to Starbucks. See you there, question mark. Dead Mother, that's a confirmed JRPG trope. Dragons, definitely back from 500 years ago, still doing something, I don't know what. Well, I know what. You don't know what. Actually, some of you do know what. I will say that the doomed hometown trope is, I don't know if subverted, but definitely, done uniquely. I still don't entirely understand why they have bathroom tinted in red, like, unless that's a hint about something that happens, like, later. Maybe it's just drawing attention to the fact that there are bathrooms in this game, which is unusual. I mean, yeah, I agree, the True Black. Here's my buddy Henry, who I have decided that's his name, whether he likes it or not. I can't play on the HDTV unless I'm running it through an HDMI from the computer because of the upscaling. I guess that dude likes me well enough just because my daddy is of age. That's. Oh my, I've explained this so many times, but considering that the old streams are going to probably fizzle out after I've caught back up, the dragon tier in the corner of the text box that appears sometimes but not always ranges from black to rainbow and indicates how much of an individual NPC likes you or how they feel towards you. The darker colors are less, like, somewhere around orange and yellow. It kind of evens out to neutral, and the bright blues are the ones where they, like, are crazy about you. Actually, I suppose you have a point. Bathrooms and technology levels would be rather indicative of technology levels. I forget, did Chrono Trigger have bathrooms? I want to say there was at least one toilet in that game. I know Final Fantasy VI did. Oh my, I'm gonna have to check out the Gaia LP as well. My first trilogy of streams with this actual group where I actually got serious following Seiken Densetsu 3, which was, if nothing else, more of a starter stream where before I had perfected things. Soul Blazer, Illusion of Gaia, and Terranigma, and it's just one of my favorite trilogies, basically of all time, and I'm very curious to see what you have to say. Ah, the not very much seen beak that we missed a lot of in Breath of Fire 1 due to Marlboro 3 smoking. Now, how much have you played Illusion of Gaia? Is this a first run, or have you done it several in the past? That was dangerous. I almost died. I would have if that battle weren't scripted. See, I wish that I could go that long without playing Gaia. Because then I could possibly forget a little. I've just played it so many damn times, like, there's no forgetting anything really, like, Red Jewel locations. I've never run out of HP from a crit on that, but I did watch some videos of what happens, like, if you kill it. I think the game crashes, I can't remember. Or does it not? I may be thinking of something else. Absolutely not true. Every dragon needs a wizard. Every heavy metal album pretty much proves that. I'm not talking about new metal, I'm talking about, like, you know, that shit from the 80s, like, anything like Molly Hatchety or, Dian, you've given me a great idea for some fan art that I can't say if it's actually been done or not. How to Train Your Dragon, Breath of Fire. Hey, I love the 80s. You take that as a diss? When someone talks about metal, usually they're talking about something a little newer. In my head, all I hear is, you know, Iron Maiden and Poison. Alice Cooper. Well, definitely a little bit of Andrew WK, but that's not so much 80s. Yes, I will close my eyes. No. No. Don't want that, especially if it's my mother. I feel like my coworkers have to be getting frustrated with the constant Alice Cooper and Andrew WK coming from my iPod. Red Dragon tier, that's definitely a bad sign. These people who knew me and sort of liked me now seem very disinterested in my existence. And Henry thinks I'm a thief now, that's great. Saint Eva, there's that name. Kevin the Landstander, I stand on the land. What? You know, what I find really interesting, and maybe I'm just going out of my way to think about things, this is the woman who liked me most in town according to that dragon tier. Now she hates me almost the most. I deduce that based on this, this is a woman who does not trust easily. And because she sees me, like, as a stranger, apparently, she hates my guts. But because she knew me so well, she liked me more. Like, I don't know. I mean, maybe this woman has trust issues. Maybe I'm looking into an NPC too much, but... I miss home movies. It's been so long since I've seen that, I don't remember really any of it. Well, it is my home, but okay. Can you imagine the feeling of strangeness if you went back to your own home, there was a strange old man living in there, and he told you you could stay there for free? And think of it as your home. Well, the average person would probably kick his ass, but Ryu is a kid, so... Silence. Silence. I have a dog buddy. Goodbye, town I've lived in all my life. Yeah, I thought it was gonna rain here earlier, but it never happened. The sky was positively, rainish. Better go into this cave. But it never happened, and I always find that weird. But he chooses not to kick the old man's bottom. I sure am glad you stole that candle from my bedroom, asshole. Yeah, Bo, you're really smart, wanting to follow the demonic scaled tail that is as large as 5 children. Yeah, I'm tired of making the same joke 3 times, but the ones that I can remember, I figure... See, now I've streamed this game recently enough, I can remember some of what I had said during the original stream. Redoing Terranigma is gonna be another thing entirely, and I'm gonna have to do that because I'm missing a big chunk of the middle of the game. I probably won't bother with Soul Blazer or Gaia. I really just love this dude's dialogue. Oh, hey, a tree stick. Shorts are easy and are comfy and easy to wear. I'm not gonna swipe your jokes. Although, when I was rewatching my Final Fantasy 1 stream, let me see you open the gate, Destined Child. Destined Child, you know, the strength of God. I love how he just rambles on and on. I did notice I stole one of H.C. Bailey's jokes. Subconsciously, I will admit, but it just hit me where I kept saying fiends, how fiends were capitalized. I have this dream all the time. from a young age, I had dreams about this, like, dude with, like, bleach blonde, slicked back hair, with these massive claws for arms, who would just, like, run out of my parents' room and, like, slice me to ribbons. And I was having these dreams probably before I was 5. I think it had something to do with watching Fright Night that young. Yeah, child locks on TV stations and DVD media, what is that? I mean, I watched stuff that would have been rated R with my parents in my young years, like... it is a combination of things that I messed up. First off, I decided I really didn't want to mess with the Woodhouse Carpenter. Granted, I would get some really good items off of him. In the spirit of keeping the game a little more difficult, I decided, well, I don't really want to mess with that, and I like the aesthetic. As far as town, like the town goes, I thought it would be more fun to pick interesting and fun villagers rather than useful villagers that'll make things easier on me. Because I never do that, ever. I always am like, well, let's just take the guy that does this good thing for you. 10 years later, I'm still level 1. Beyond that, I didn't like that I was wasting so much time fishing on camera. I feel like that's just a waste of time for the viewer. Instead, I did a bunch of hunting. Hunting is quicker and more profitable. But I did so off-screen. How would you pronounce that? Is that like, Bosch? Like the Mighty Boosh. I'm old Greg. Like, I think it would have been really fun to be a graphic designer in the 90s. Like, the level of detail that went into, like, say, that bookshelf, if you really pay attention to every sprite, or, like, every pixel on the sprite. Yeah, my dad did disappear, and I have nightmares about it every night, you ass. Thanks for reminding me. Stuff. We do the weird stuff. Sometimes I wonder how many pop culture references are in these streams. Yes, by Antidote. Tiro, you were like the... I don't even know how to describe what you do for me. You're like my, you're like my Otacon. You're the Otacon to my snake. I get a message from you, that's all, and you're all, yo, Snake, you should buy antidotes, and I'm like, I would rather buy Marlboro 3s, because I'm Snake and I smoke. Let's visit my sexy ginger landlady, who I should really draw and post pictures of on Reddit. Actually, you know what? That's an interesting idea right there. I should just draw, like, random NPCs that have no bearing on the story. Well, you know, Tiro does get to shout that quite a bit, because I'll forget to save. Like a fool. So, which one of you was it that pointed out the wet bed? I remember it was someone, but I don't remember who. Ourselves a Monero. And a ginger innkeeper. Yeah, I do find that interesting that she lets us, like, keep the apartment forever. Giggle, giggle. You know, no, Mina, they just call that running away. What Susie is doing is running away. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Ranger, are you working? You are working hard. It sounds like a... It's absolutely ridiculous. It sounds like a child's book. Oh man, can you imagine a Breath of Fire 2 children's book? That would just be bad. Well, it would be amazing, but the subject matter alone. And it's also nice to know I wasn't the only one who was thinking about Power Rangers. Nice before when we were fighting each other and killing each other? Jeez, Dragon God. Which now makes it time to load up my equivalent save where I did 3 hours of hunting while watching anime. Jubei-chan, to be specific. And this is the result of my labor. You'll notice I actually have two of the rare eggs, which is basically a revive. Gotten by killing the birds at the hunting grounds. Not quite sure how I did that. And for the moment, we're just gonna sell one stack, because I think that's more than enough. Yes, 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 antidotes. I'm not even going to buy Boa Salad Bowl because I know I'm going to get one in this upcoming dungeon, and it just seems like a waste of money, says the man who has over 12,000 Zinni in roasts. I think he'll live. Blue suede armor? Was this a joke from your own stream, out of curiosity? I think we'll be fine with what we've got going on here. I still want to watch that after I finish up here. Who did you recruit for your town? Just, I'm wondering. Part of the reason I want to go ahead and go with the regular town is because I would like to recruit Locker. I never do the painting of the town because I much prefer having Barros to learn my spells, but I'm thinking it might be more interesting to not do that for the first time in years and see, you know, how my characters fare with only their natural abilities and a few other things, like perhaps Chop Chop from Wildcat. Ah, because Pooh sells the Moondrop, yes. Okay, I know what the others do. What does Hans do? We really need to go to the... Well, yeah. Let's go ahead and see Grassman again. Ah, yes, the item shop. Okay. Yes, I am fairly certain I will not be doing stat-boosting items this run. Despite having the town for it. Although I always did find it rather amusing to take, like, someone like Nina and just fill her with, strength bonuses. I bet the feed consists of pizza. Or crack, look at him move. Well, hello there, unique sprite that was present in the opening demo. My parents are dead, you ass. Everyone in this world loves reminding me of that. Yeah, I want to know why he doesn't. He's just like he has issues, apparently. Or she. Oh, lead off attack, that means run. Also, I think I'm gonna go ahead and switch to scramble. Bo will take a little more damage, but Ryu will take a little less. My sinuses are going crazy. I'm not sure if looking at its head would help you identify its sex, although this reminds me of something I once heard. Sex and gender are two entirely different concepts. I would much rather have sex than have gender. Oh, if it uses pollen. I would never have even thought of that. Thank Dragon God for those, armor upgrades, huh? Stop that! Defense in this game is actually useful. You know, now that I think about it, Earthbound was another one that was rather amusing to do stat manipulation on as well. The trick with rock candy, and I want to say what is it, like a sugar packet or something. I've gotten Paula's strength and guts so high that she basically like did twice the damage of Ness. Of course, that broke the game when they gained so much HP that it rolled over into nonsense text. I know that you did mention in your own LP something about a specific group of characters that I won't mention now, having the most reason to go up against the antagonist that I won't mention. Which I very much agreed with. I really should try Arkrai's Fantasia. I've heard a lot about it, like nothing specific, just this is good, play it. I would really like to get to Breath of Fire 3, so as far as the stream goes, that's my main focus, but in my personal life, I've been playing Pokemon Emerald, which I've never beaten, but third gen is my favorite. I don't know why, I just love Hoenn. Ooh, really? I never thought to use shields in Final Fantasy Legend 1 or 2, but that's definitely worth knowing is useful. Thank you. thinking. Yeah, they have about equal defense. Aside from Pokemon Emerald, I was playing Ark the Lad. I got a little distracted from that and started doing other stuff. Coldcept Saga. Preemptive assumption of needing to defend. I could really get back to Pokemon X. And oh my, I've been playing Ragnarok Odyssey Ace and Ragnarok Online 2 as well. But Tales of Exilia 2 is coming out in a very short period, so I'm definitely gonna have to pick up my Exilia 1 and maybe do a New Game Plus on that. Now, that was, Exilia was like one of my favorite games that I have ever played. I don't know why, I loved the characters, I loved the gameplay, the battles, super fun. I didn't play the original Ragnarok Odyssey, but I really love Ace. The only problem I have with it is just that it's so damn massive. There's so much collecting and so much randomness. Very grindy, but like I feel like Ace was a, well, Odyssey in general was a missed opportunity. I loved the original Ragnarok Online. However, it just, you know, it was a standard MMO, just kill stuff, level up, kill stuff, level up. I feel like if they were to release a game that had the Ragnarok Odyssey engine, but a large world with, I don't know, a free roam, but something like Ocarina of Time even would suffice. I feel like it has a really good engine for an open world game. Instead of a instanced mini-mission game. That's what I hated about Kingdom Hearts 358 over 2 days. The fact that they took this game series that worked so well with an overarching narrative and reduced it to mini-missions in order to get chunks of story. It was a good story. I liked the story. I just didn't like the mini missions to get to it. And, Tiro, yes, I may be actually playing Final Fantasy Legend 1 and 2 at some point. I've beaten both, but it has been years and years, at least 5 to 10 for each. But the Saga games, I love them. I just think that that's an underappreciated series, really. Saga Frontier was another one that was, like, amazing game, just rushed, incomplete. Alright, Dine, thank you for popping in, and I'll see you at some point soon. I'm gonna try to just beat this game in the next couple weeks. I'll have to check out your Gaia stream, because I'm rather curious about that one. But, yeah, have a good night. God, Bo is nothing but trouble. Oh, hey, why don't you push that rock? these battles are just all over. Okay, yeah, I haven't done much editing. But I will keep that in mind. Mr. Pinchpenny saving money. At least they die easily. I do know one thing, this game will go by a lot faster if I just kill things unless I get a lead-off attack, rather than trying to run away. That's what was slowing me down so much, all the fishing and trying to avoid fights. Fire rock that I'll be holding on to until Capitan, probably. I just hope that you wasn't trying to hunt Susie. My apologies, I just got a message from Pepsi. Told him to pop in. Hopefully, being at 720p, he will be able to see. I said that in rhyme. I should do that all the time. Help me is bolded. the game really wants you to know that someone needs help. That's basically what's going on there, I'm pretty sure. This isn't good. I forgot to heal. Well, way to go, me. That was really smart. Oops. Yeah, I'm gonna die anyway. Let's just reset. I saved. I hope. Yeah, I saved. I saved you. That thing. Like the ones I see at work. I like that we already have a returning boss from Breath of Fire 1, like, this early, even if it was a very minor boss. Take that. Thank you. Well, now I'm rather irritated because Pepsi is still not saying anything even in 720p. It's still alive! Actually, if you check my logs of my old streams, I have already played Illusion of Gaia as part of a trilogy. I played Soul Blazer, Illusion of Gaia, and Terranigma, one after another. And that was actually probably the best set of streams that I have done ever, and also one of my favorite trilogies of games. Dine is apparently doing Illusion of Gaia right now, and if you would be at all interested, I'm willing to restream it just for fun. The old episodes are the better episodes, because if I do it again, it'll just be because I'm playing it and don't have much else to say. But I do have to restream Terranigma, as mentioned earlier, because I have the beginning and the end, but not the middle. I apologize for radio silence. I just don't have a lot to say right now. I'm kind of just focusing on the game. If I have anything to add, I will, and if anyone wants to chat, I'll respond. I'm just at the moment having a bit of inspiration disappearance. So, I actually, well, I was gonna say something, but first I think I'm gonna go open the door and have a cigarette. I'll be right back. I was talking and I had it muted. So there's an interesting story behind how I started smoking cigarettes. It has to do with Metal Gear Solid. Solid Snake smokes cigarettes. End of story. And don't think the irony of his health bar going down as he does so is lost on me. Hey Pepsi. Is it working? Did your thing go, or is it just... And I apologize, Tiro. I should have been streaming earlier. I just... so many things I try to squeeze into the week. But as this is mostly catch-up... Ketchup as in K-A-T-C-H, not as in ketchup or catsup, the condiment. We should be okay, I mean... I'm more so worried about getting back to Sima Fort than anything at this point. At which point, the conversation and regularity can return more to, you know, just replaying something. Kinda overkill. I am gonna need this stick rod. Well, I'm not really worried about bait. I accidentally bought an extra antidote, but whatever, I'm sure I'm gonna use it. I'll remove two stacks of roasts. Later, buddy. I will try to stream earlier in the day next time. And definitely keep me updated on your Sword of Mana guide. I'm curious about that. So anyway, what I was thinking, that I was gonna say earlier before the urge to be a Solid Snake got to me, I've actually been thinking about using my streaming experience for the sake of radio. I actually have great interest in radio DJing. I don't know if I have a radio voice, I definitely have a radio face. But talking to you lovely people has kind of given me some experience in talking to lovely people. Nothing else in another semester or so, I may try to get on the campus radio station. I assume you get credit for that. Windia, huh? That place is still around. Yeah, friends. Oh yeah, because 500 coins, that's worth so much when I have all those roasts. Ominous. Hey, look at me, I'm the Lord Commander of the Rangers. Oh, Bo sleeps in the wet bed. That's telling about his character. I've always wondered about this eye that's viewing this. I wonder if it's the eye from the opening intro. The magic hood. I don't think he ever mentioned the magic hood, did he? Well, yeah, because you're the thief. Yet you don't kick them out. You're a terrible landlord. Never change. These people are awful. I would not be friends with them. Years now. I can. No, I really can't. That's my buddy I'm talking about. That was a unique sprite. You couldn't tell that he was a dog before? Talk to him in a minute. I find it rather appropriate that there are no items for me to take in this dude's house, considering that he was already stolen from. I really love the Kilgore Trout reference. If you're at all familiar with Kurt Vonnegut's work, Kilgore Trout is a character, an author within Vonnegut's novels, who always acts as a author avatar. Love me some good Vonnegut. Slaughterhouse-Five. God Bless You, Mr. Rosewater was one of the best books I've ever read. Elliot Rosewater was a very relatable character for me. Cat's Cradle was another excellent one. Well, yeah, I do think you stole something, but I'm gonna say no because you're my friend. Run, run, or you'll be well done. A sweating trash can. I love the moving trash can sprite. Nero from the ruins. Yes, I remember. We just went there, dude. Yesterday. Oh, man, I'm tired. Huh. I miss my Yakety Sax button. I'm just gonna be humorous. I assume that the comic book was like a porno or something. You know how censorship goes. I'm just gonna say Bo because it's funny. Oh, okay. This guy's my buddy, apparently. He's a good judge of character. Either that or he and I are bad judges of character, one or the other. Thank you. Yeah, I am curious. This is a terrible move, and I shouldn't be doing this. What do we got going on over here? That's what I want to know. It's not gonna let me run. It's okay, I'll kill some stuff. It's not like it's a shit ton of experience anyway. Oh, there's a hunting spot now that I can't use it. Hoodlums. Oh, the Birubiru is gonna kill me. Oh no, that was lucky. Oh, shit, that's not good. And because I'm a curious cat. Why so serious? Yeah, Joker's singular possessive. The Joker, as in a guy named the Joker. That's clearly someone doesn't know their grammar. Joker's apostrophe, not Joker apostrophe S. This is the hideout of one guy named the Joker who is incredibly possessive of his hideout. Dead. Well, I like that starts me behind this guy. That amuses me. But I've lost all of my damn gold. So, that is a frustrating situation. One in which it's probably appropriate. Okay, we're not gonna leave this on. However, just for Tiro, who has already gone to sleep. Okay. Yakety Sax makes everything better. If we have another situation like that, I'll probably go ahead and do that again, but in the meantime, nah. It's morning. I'm wide awake. It's morning. I wish I had a thunder staff to use S boom on all these guys for quick kills. That's not good. This old house. Well, I bet it did smell bad. It was filled with porno magazines and trash. Weird formatting. What fell? It has no roof. I should. And the epic song. Save. Hashtag save. That's good to know. Forgot I need a stick rod as well. Thank you. Oh, looks like I had the mic off. I'm just looking up whether or not donations matter. Okay, not important. We're good. Well, it is important, just not immediately. So, yo, Pepsi, are you still here? I don't know for sure. I know you said you got it working. That was stupid of me, incredibly. And I just lost all my money again. And I have no idea when I last saved. Gah. Okay. Lesson learned. Lesson being, save more often and rest more often. this stupid stuff again. Other lesson being deposit gold into the bank frequently. An accident to use two of those. And we've already talked to all these duders, so I'm just gonna run to the church, pick up that herb, buy my stuff, and save. Damn time I've done this. Did I heal? Yeah, we're good. That'll do. This isn't good. For business or anybody. Oh, wow. I dodged a critical, that's amazing.
I don't 100% remember.